In the name of Allah, the most loving, caring and beneficent. Assalamu alaikum 8th class, welcome to another online session. Today we will start lecture number 7 and the topics which are included in lecture number 7 are, first of all, from English A we shall do chapter number 2, Ida, a dialogue. And from this chapter, we shall do translation of page number 7, half portion, first half portion of page number 7. And then from English B, we shall do use of has, have and had. And we shall do introduction of this topic. Okay students, if we think about that, what is a dialogue? First of all, we will discuss the definition of a dialogue, that what is dialogue. Actually, a dialogue is a conversation between two or more person. When two person are talking to each other, that one is dialogue. Okay, first of all, we will write difficult meanings of paragraph number 1. You have to write them on your book. First one is been, rehna, met, mile, job, mulazmat, no, jante hain, particularly, khas taur par, because, kyunke, ill, bimar. Okay, here is the chapter number 2, the first portion of this chapter. Qasim, assalamu alaikum uncle. Uncle, wa alaikum assalam. Where have you been, Qasim? We have met after a long time. Qasim, I have been to Saudi Arabia, uncle, and I have just come back. Uncle, why did you go to Saudi Arabia? Qasim, you know father is doing a job there and mother is there too. I went to see them, particularly mother, because she was ill. Okay, from start. Qasim, assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum, chacha jaan. Uncle, wa alaikum assalam. Wa alaikum assalam, same. Where have you been, Qasim? Tum kahan rahe ho, Qasim? We have met, hum mile hain, after a long time, bade arse baad. So the sentence will be, wa alaikum assalam. Tum kahan rahe ho, Qasim? Hum bade arse baad mile hain. Qasim, I have been to Saudi Arabia. मैं सऊदी अरेबिया सऊदी अरब रहा हूँ अंकल चचा जान एंड आई हैव जस्ट कम बैक और मैं अभी वापस आया हूँ सो द सेंटेंस विल बी मैं सऊदी अरब रहा हूँ चचा जान और मैं अभी वापस आया हूँ अंकल व्हाई डिड यू गो टू सऊदी अरेबिया चचा जान आप सऊदी अरब क्यों गए थे कासिम यू नो फादर इज डूइंग अ जॉब देयर कासिम आप जानते हैं अब्बू जान वहाँ मुलाजमत कर रहे हैं एंड मदर इज देयर टू और अम्मी भी वहीं हैं आई वेंट टू सी देम मैं उनसे मिलने गया था पर्टिकुलरली ख़ास तौर पर मदर अम्मी से बिकॉज शी वॉज इल क्योंकि वो बीमार थी सो द सेंटेंस विल बी आप जानते हैं अब्बू जान वहाँ मुलाजमत कर रहे हैं और अम्मी भी वहीं हैं एंड द सेकेंड सेंटेंस मैं उनसे मिलने गया था ख़ास तौर पर अम्मी से क्योंकि वो बीमार थी सो दिस इज़ द फर्स्ट पोर्शन ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 2 सो स्टूडेंट्स हियर इज़ द सेकेंड पोर्शन मीनिंग्स फुली मुकम्मल तौर पर रिकवर्ड सेहतयाब हैज़ री ओपन दोबारा खुला है ओकेशन छुट्टियाँ मिस्ड रह गया एक्स्ट्रा अजाफी एफर्ट कोशिश easily, baasani, deficiency, kami, certainly, yakinan, important, aham, lessons, spark, pretty, sakht, glad, khushi, already, pehle se, regularly, baqaidagi, helping, madad karna. So these are the meanings of second portion. You have to write them on your book. Okay students, here is the second portion. Uncle, I am sorry to hear that. How is she now, Qasim? She is fine, uncle. Thank you. She has now fully recovered. Uncle, your school, I hear, has just reopened after vacation and I don't think you have missed much. I think with just a little extra effort, you could easily make up your deficiency in your studies. Qasim, no, uncle. I have certainly missed many important lessons and I know I would have to work pretty hard. I am glad I have already started doing so. I have started attending classes regularly and my brother has started helping me too. Now here is the explanation. अंकल आई एम सॉरी टू हियर डैट। चचा जान मुझे ये सुनकर अफसोस हुआ। हाउ इज ही नाउ, अब वो कैसी हैं? मुझे ये सुनकर अफसोस हुआ, अब वो कैसी हैं? कासिम शी इज फाइन अंकल, अब वो ठीक हैं चचा जान। थैंक यू, आपका शुक्रिया। शी हैज़ नाउ फुली रिकवर्ड, अब वो मुकम्मल तौर पर सेहतयाब हो गई हैं। अब वो ठीक हैं चचा जान, आपका शुक्रिया, अब वो मुकम्मल तौर पर सेहतयाब हो गई हैं। अंकल योर स्कूल, अंकल चचा जान योर स्कूल, आपका स्कूल आई हेयर मैंने सुना है हैज़ जस्ट री ओपन्ड आफ्टर वेकेशन, स्कूल की छुट्टियों के बाद अभी दोबारा खुला है। एंड आई डोंट थिंक सो, और मैं नहीं समझता, यू हैव मिस्ड मच, आपका ज़्यादा काम रह गया है। मैंने सुना है आपका स्कूल छुट्टियों के बाद अभी दोबारा खुला है, और मैं नहीं समझता आपका ज़्यादा काम रह गया है। आई थिंक विद जस्ट अ लिटल एफर्ट, मैं समझता हूँ थोड़ी सी इजाफी कोशिश से, यू कुड ईजिली मेकअप, आप बआसानी पूरा कर सकते हैं योर डेफिशेंसी इन योर स्टडीज़, अपनी पढ़ाई में अपनी कमी। मैं समझता हूँ थोड़ी सी इजाफी कोशिश से आप बआसानी पढ़ाई में अपनी कमी को पूरा कर सकते हो। कासिम नो अंकल, कासिम नहीं चचा जान, आई हैव सर्टेनली, मेरे यकीनन मिस्ड मैनी इम्पॉर्टेंट, बहुत से रह गए हैं इम्पॉर्टेंट लेसन्स, अहम असबाक। नहीं चचा जान, मेरे यकीनन बहुत से अहम असबाक रह गए हैं। एंड आई नो, और मैं जानता हूँ, आई वुड हैव टू वर्क प्रीटी हार्ड, मुझे सख्त मेहनत करना पड़ेगी। आई एम ग्लैड, मुझे खुशी है, आई हैव ऑलरेडी, मैं पहले ही से स्टार्टेड डूइंग सो, ऐसा करना शुरू कर दिया है, मैंने पहले ही से ऐसा करना शुरू कर दिया है। आई हैव स्टार्टेड अटेंडिंग क्लासेस, मैंने क्लासेस लेना शुरू कर दी हैं रेगुलरली, बाकायदगी से क्लासे लेना शुरू कर दी हैं। एंड माई ब्रदर हैज स्टार्टेड हेल्पिंग मी टू, और मेरे भाई ने भी मेरी मदद करना शुरू कर दी है। मुझे खुशी है, मैंने पहले ही ऐसा करना शुरू कर दिया है, मैंने बाकायदगी से क्लासें लेना शुरू कर दी हैं, और मेरे भाई ने भी मेरी मदद करना शुरू कर दी है। सो हियर इज द सेकेंड पोर्शन ऑफ दिस लेक्चर। नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव टू डू समथिंग फ्रॉम इंग्लिश बी, वी विल डू यूज ऑफ हैज, हैव एंड ओके। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी शैल डू यूज ऑफ हैज, हैव इन सिंपल सेंटेंसेस। इन प्रेजेंट टेंस वी यूज हैज, हैव व्हेन वी शो पोजेशन टू एनीथिंग और प्लेस। किसी भी जगह या चीज की मलकियत को शो करने के लिए हम लोग हैज और हैव यूज करते हैं। वी हैव टू यूज हैज विद ही, शी, इट एंड सिंगुलर नाउंस। एंड वी हैव टू यूज हैव विद आई, यू, वी, दे एंड प्लूरल नाउंस। Now here are some examples of simple sentences of use of has and have. He has a knife. He is a singular and we have to use has with it. Then here is, we have to use have with I. So I have a fine camera. Then the horse is a singular here. We have to use has with it. The horse has four hooves. Now use of had in simple sentences. In past tense we have to use had in past tense and we have to use has, have in present tense. So in past tense we use had when we show possession to anything or place. When we are showing possession in past tense to anything or place, then we have to use had with it. We have to use had with he, she, it, I, you, we, they, singular and plural nouns. It means that we have to use had with all pronouns as well as singular and plural nouns. It means that we have to use had with all subjects. Here are the examples of use of had. First of all, he had a pen. We have to use had with it, had with he, and then the servant had 10 rupees. Now again, this is singular and we have to use had because we have to use had with our subject. Then my brother had no land. All these sentences are showing possession to things. Now negative sentences. Whenever we make negative sentences, we use not or no after has, have and had. We had discussed in the previous lecture is, am, are and was were, and we had used not after these helping verbs. Now here are the helping verbs has, have and had, and we have to use not and no with it. Now where we have to use not with not and where we have to use no, here is the explanation. When we don't know the number of things, when we don't know the number of things, we use no after has, have, had. For example, the beggar has no stick. We don't know the numbers of stick, so we have to use no with it. When we know the number of things, we use not after has, have, had. When we are knowing about the number of things, we have to use not. For example, the horses have not three hoofs. Now we have to know that there are three hoofs. Now we use not. We have to use no when we don't know the number of things, and we use not when we know the number of things, and we have to use not and no after the helping verb has, have and have had. And has, have, had we used in the when we are showing possession. When we are showing possession is present in present tense, we have to use has, have, and when we are showing possession in past tense, we have to use had. Now we will discuss in how to use has, have, had in interrogative sentences. In interrogative sentences, we use has, have and had at the start of the sentence. We had discussed in the previous lecture, we have to use helping verb at the start of the sentence. So here is the same thing. We have to use has, have and had at the start of the sentence. For example, has the king a crown on his head? We have to use has at the start of the sentence, and we have to use has because the king is a singular and this is in the present tense. Then have they some money? Now they are plural. We have to use have with it, and we have to use have at the start of the sentence, and we have to use question mark at the end of the sentence. Now here is the third example. This is the example of past tense. We have to use had with it. Had the passengers ticket? Now we have to use had at the start of the sentence. In this point, we use has, have, had at the start of the sentence because we are doing interrogative sentences. Now there are double interrogative sentences. In double interrogative sentences, we use why, who, when, whose, whom, where, how at the start of the sentence first of all. Then after it, we will use has, have and had. And after it, we will use subject. First of all, we have to use why, who, when, whose, whom, where and how at the start of the sentence. After them, we have to use has, have and had. And then we use subject. For example, in the first example, first of all, I have written why, then have, then subject they, a camera. Why have they a camera? Then where is the first interrogative sense, then has is the second one. These are the double interrogative. Then there is subject he, a horse. Where has he a horse? Now when had she a doll? When is the first interrogative showing, then had is another, then she is a subject. When had she a doll? Question mark. Now in the negative and interrogative, there in the sentence there when there is a sentence included negative also and interrogative also, then we have to do in negative interrogative sentences, we use has, had at the start of the sentence, and we use not and no after the subject. It means that we have to use has, have, had at the start of the sentence, and And for negative, we have to use not after the subject. We will not use not and no before the subjects. For example, has the beggar no bowl? Has is at the start of the sentence, but the no is after the subject. Subject is the beggar, and we have to use no after the subject. Has the beggar bowl? Then have they not? Have is the interrogative, we have to use at the start of the sentence. Then we have to use subject, and after the subject we have to use not. Have they not 3 goats in their house? Then had is the interrogative. Had is showing that it is interrogative. Then subject, then after it we have to use not. Had he not 5 books? So these are the examples of has, have and had. Okay, dear students, in this lecture we had done first of all lesson number 2, a dialogue, and we had done first half portion of page number 7. You can open page number 7 side by side when you are listening this lecture. Then after it, we had done use of has, have and had. We had done introduction. We had discussed about the simple sentences of these helping verbs, then negative sentences, then interrogative sentences, and double interrogative, and then negative interrogative sentences. We had discussed all these sentences in this lecture. I hope that you have understood all these. You have one thing you have to do is you have to make sentences related to these has, have and had, as then you will be able to understand them more. Okay, now I am signing out. Take good care of yourself and your family. Thank you. Allah Hafiz. Take care.